Hey, what's up everyone? Today I'm going to be unboxing this new ASUS Blue Cave router I bought. It's an AC2600. I saw it a couple weeks ago on Slick Deals for 90 bucks, and it sold out pretty quick. So it was from Best Buy, and then I kind of forgot about it, and I saw it kind of just searching, going through Slick Deals, and I found it for 100 on Amazon. Back ordered for about a week and a half. It ended up being a week when I ended up getting it, ordered it, and then it ended up on my door from Amazon. Anyway, it's pretty good speed, AC2600 for 100 bucks plus tax, which is really a good deal. Everything else kind of comparable to it online was in the 150 and up range, so I figured I'd give it a shot. It's got a weird design, no antennas, everything's kind of built inside. It's got the cave round tube thing. Box makes it look bigger than it really is, but it looks like it's really just this piece right here, this part. It's got the hole in the center. I read some reviews on it after I bought it. It runs an Intel chipset. It doesn't run the normal Broadcom that every other ASUS and a lot of the WRT routers out there. You know, I was gonna run it on the stock firmware anyway, so I didn't care. One of the main reasons I did, because I've got another router that I want to run the AI mesh network across my house with this, but anyway. So pretty cool of you. It makes pretty good decoration too if you leave it out. I'm gonna have it in a closet, so I don't really care. If you look in the back, it's got four regular download ports, Ethernet and switch ports. It's got the one WAN port, it's got the WPS, a USB 3.0 blue USB, and the regular power in and the power on off button. I'm gonna be running as my main router. So it comes with your regular ASUS power supply, a Ethernet cable, that's about it. What I'm gonna be running on the node for this guy is my old AC1900. It's the, if you guys, the T-Mobile cell spot one. I'm not running T-Mobile cell spot software on it. I've had this one for probably 3.5 years now. Bought it for, I think, 50 bucks on Slick Deals when T-Mobile was clearing it out. And it's actually a very popular router. It's really an AC68U from ASUS. And then I think the rest of the world might run as the AC1900. Basically, the internals are the same, except it's got the T-Mobile branding and T-Mobile lock software. They've tried their hardest over the years to lock this thing and relock it. When I originally got this one, I had to go through this long, probably took me a couple hours to figure out, but once I figured out the first time on mine, I was able to do it to three other routers that I got from the rest of my family. But anyway, I installed it back then with, I think it was 876 was the software, and I didn't really touch it for 3 years until recently when I wanted to do the AI mesh. Then I found out that they, ASUS and T-Mobile, with it being so rampant and them, everybody taking it and hacking it and putting Merlin and the stock software on there. Actually, starting with 380, I believe, firmware 380, they wrote in there a script to relock these back to T-Mobile. There's a workaround. Some guys figured it out online. You have to reload the bootloader again, basically clean up all the old T-Mobile scripts that were still written in the firmware of it to basically hide it from the the ASUS software, because the problem everybody was having was when they had the 376 software, they you could upgrade it using the web interface, but once they loaded it, it saw that it still had T-Mobile stuff on there, so it would revert it all back to T-Mobile, and then you have to go through the whole bootloader process again. The bootloader process was the hardest part of that full upgrade. So luckily, I kind of waited that out. I saw it about 6 months ago that they started locking it, and then I didn't really mess with it because I was using it as an access point across the house anyways, across my Ethernet, so I didn't really care. But anyway, 6 months, I looked at it last week. They just recently, September of 2019 now, so about a month ago, they they came out with a new firmware and some guys hacked it already. So they they figured out the bootloader, they erased all the old T-Mobile stuff and all that. So I followed all those directions, and I'll probably post it on this link if anybody's interested. If you were able to hack this thing the first time, you should be able to hack it again the second time. It took me a while to figure it out. It was more trying to clean up everything and making sure it was 100%. But once I got it close to what I thought was 100%, I just took a shot at it and loaded the latest firmware, and it took without reverting back, so it was good. And I actually ended up using Merlin. So I'm thinking I'm running Merlin 80.13. I think 1.3 is the most current version. And Merlin started supporting AI mesh with ASUS. So one of the things that if you're gonna use AI mesh with your main router is you gotta reset this thing back to factory settings and then go through the process of setting up the AI mesh when they're right next to each other. I'm gonna go ahead and set this thing up. All right, first thing I'm gonna do is plug up the power to this thing. Plug up to one of the regular Ethernet ports on there.
And plug it to the computer.
One of the key things is when you use a laptop or any other computer, make sure you turn off your Wi-Fi so it's not connecting to your regular network. You go in here and you're gonna go to 192.168.1.1, which is the factory setting for this. And the ASUS router is gonna take you through their wizard. So it says, please plug in cable to WAN port, system will detect your network settings. So I'm not gonna do that right now, but usually you would do that when you're connecting your modem to this. I'm gonna set that up later. So I'm gonna go to manual. So I'm gonna have it automatically get my IP, and I'm gonna create my name and password here. And once you change your router login name and password, so you guys gonna do this however you need to on your router. Set it up as a default router. This again. I'm gonna go back into 192.168.1.1 again and log in. Go into the regular web interface. So it says, please ensure the cable is plugged into the WAN port. So right now it's giving me an error because I don't have my internet set up yet. So I'm gonna go in here. So if you go to network map in here, here's where you're gonna set up the AI mesh though. All right, so I'm in my home office where I have my old AC1900 or the T-Mobile router set up. The first thing that you have to do before you set up the AI mesh is to reset your old router back to factory settings. That's one of the instructions for AI mesh. So on this thing, there's a little button right here that you gotta push with a pen or something that's kind of indented in. So you hold that button down for 5 seconds and it will reset everything to factory settings. Get the reset there. Let that thing go. It's gonna take a couple minutes to reboot on that one. That thing's been rebooted. So I actually have to plug this thing up to the modem. My modem is in a network closet on the other side of the house. So what I'm gonna do is, since I have Ethernet all through my house, I'm just gonna end up running the cable that goes here that I'm using as my backhaul or across the house cable, and I'm gonna actually plug that into the WAN port and then the modem on the other side. The one thing with my modem is that it's a combo router modem, so I have to actually disable that that modem, and I probably need to reset the IP address on that because this one has the same 192.168.1.1 IP address, so that they're going to conflict with each other when they see the same address. So I have to reset that one to a different number, probably like .2.1 or something, so that way they don't conflict.
See what happens when I plug up the WAN port to my network. See if it applies. So it's connected and might be working. So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to do the AI mesh network process on here. So what it's going to do is going to ask you to plug up your other router into there, and it's going to run through its whole thing. So you just click on the AI mesh, and then you want to search. There's a search button over here, and I'm going to do a wire backhaul on this, so that way. And the thing with AI, this AI meshes, it'll actually, if you have it on an Ethernet, the two modems on the same network, or the two routers on the same network, it will actually select whether the either, you know, the AC band or the hardwire band, whichever one has faster internet at the time. So that's one of the cool things with the AI mesh. I got everything reset correctly now. That thing took a couple resets, the T-Mobile one, to kick in. I got this one connected to the modem and everything, so it's got an IP address. So I hit find AI, or you hit the AI mesh, and there's a search button over here. Hit search, and it, once it discovers the other node router, it'll ask if you want to connect to it, and you say yes, and then you end up waiting about 100 seconds. It takes, it's about 30% right now, so it took about 100 seconds. It's going about 1-2 seconds each, actually. So I'm letting that upload the settings and everything into the node. Once that's done, everything, all your settings from your main router should be on that router, as far as your password, your SSID, and all that. And then once that's done, then you'll have a nice or seamless mesh network in your house. So you want to put that on one end of the house, and you want to put the other one on the other end. If you're using it just wirelessly, you got to make sure that there's they're within a distance where they can create the mesh node. In my case, it won't matter because I'll have a wired backhaul. I'm going to use the Ethernet that I already have in my house to run over to this second router. So it'll actually, you know, with the AI mesh, it'll switch between the wireless and the wired depending on what the network speeds are at the time. But most likely it'll be under the wired most of the time, just because of maybe the distance and the walls. The one thing, you know, my house is gigabit, which at one point was fast. Now with all this AC 1900 and 2600, the AC band is actually faster than gigabit. So that's one thing, if you don't know much about networks, that's pretty fast. But then it's also, you know, how close you are to the devices and everything. Now I was going to ask you to hook up a wire between the router and the other one for the wired backhaul side of it. So I'm gonna set that up right now so it recognizes that. So I went through a couple more settings, and I ended up, for my simplicity, I left 192.168.1.1 on the modem, and I changed the, you know, my routers to 192.168.2.1, so that way I remember it, because around here, like my printer and the routers and all that, I give them static IP, so I remember them, and I leave a label on them so I can log into them later, just because I have so much devices all connected to my network. So anyway, got everything all set up. I'm gonna end up moving these things all around the house and get everything all situated. So if you guys like my video, you know, any of this information, and find it useful, just like, share, and subscribe to your channel. I'm gonna post every time I do stuff around the house, whether it's networking, cars, fixing the house, whatever it is. I'm just gonna make videos and post on YouTube and let you guys, you know, all you DIYers, kind of learn something or figure stuff out if you guys are trying to go through the same stuff I am. Anyway, thanks for watching.